Hey guys, welcome back. Today I am sharing super tasty, delicious, juicy Madta Kaja. By the way, have you ever tried Kaja with whole wheat flour and jaggery? If not, and if you are wondering how to, you should definitely try this recipe because everyone who eats this will 100% think they are store-bought sweets. Surprise your family with soft and juicy inside and crunchy outside melting Kaja for all special occasions. So now let's get into the video and see the process. To start with, measure 2 cups of whole wheat flour that we use for making normal rotis and transfer to your mixing bowl. Now add a pinch of salt. This little salt will enhance the sweetness. Now a big fat pinch of baking soda. This baking soda makes the dough flaky. Now here I'm adding 4 spoons of ghee. This 4 spoons is equal to 1/4 cup of ghee. So after adding ghee, give a good mix. In case if you don't have ghee, you can use butter which is at room temperature. After mixing the ghee in the flour, here you can see we are able to hold it as a ball. This shows we added right amount of ghee to make flaky layers. And now here you can see I'm adding water gradually and mixing the dough. This way gradual adding of water helps you to know the correct consistency of the dough. Usually these kajas are made using all-purpose flour, but as all-purpose flour is refined and processed, so I don't prefer using all-purpose flour personally, so I replaced it with whole wheat flour. And also I replaced normal white sugar with the jaggery powder because white sugar is chemically processed and not safe for health. So with all the healthy substitutions, when we are able to make perfect sweet shop style kaja, definitely you don't prefer to buy from the store next time. As we used whole wheat flour, we need to knead the dough for at least 10 minutes because kneading helps in making flaky layers of kaja. Here you can see the consistency of the dough should be like this, very soft. Once the soft dough is formed, now allow this to rest for at least 20 minutes. After 20 minutes, our dough is well rested. Now we have to knead the dough once again. After kneading the dough very well, now keep it aside and dust the working surface with the dry flour. Make sure to have a large working surface because we are rolling the entire dough at a time. Here you can see I'm rolling this dough into a thin and flat sheet. Make sure to roll the dough to a sheet that is as thin as possible because the thin sheet will give that flaky texture and it helps in absorbing the juice inside. Here you can see we got a very thin sheet and now onto this I'm applying little amount of ghee. After adding the ghee, here I'm spreading the ghee with hand so that it is equally distributed onto the entire thin sheet. After spreading the ghee, here I'm dusting with the dry flour. This dry flour that we are spreading helps in forming separate flaky layers. After dusting with the dry flour, now start folding from the edges. Make sure to roll into a thin and intact roll without leaving any gaps. While rolling the sheet also, here you can see I'm dusting the flour so that the layers will be visible once it is fried. Here you can see we have this uneven edges, so I'm cutting those uneven edges to make a perfect straight line. After cutting those edges, here I'm taking those pieces and I'm placing in the center. This way we will get an even roll. So here on both sides I did the same thing. On the other side also I cut the uneven edges and I place those strips in the center. After placing the edge strips, once again I'm dusting with the dry flour and then rolling the sheet. Make sure to dust each time after every roll so that this helps in forming a flaky layers. After reaching the end, here I'm wetting the end part with a little amount of water so that it is sealed properly. After applying water, roll it and try to stretch it very gently without force. Now just tap on the entire roll and start cutting into 1-inch pieces. And while cutting into 1-inch pieces, move the knife back and forth so that the layers will not be disturbed. After the entire log is cut into 1-inch pieces, now take each piece and press with a finger and then roll very gently to make it little flat. Likewise, continue the process and make all the pieces ready. With this, all the pieces are ready, so keep them aside. And in a saucepan, here I'm adding 2 1/4 cups of jaggery powder and 3/4 cup of water to melt this jaggery. So for 2 cups of whole wheat flour, we added 2 1/4 cups of jaggery powder. Keep stirring occasionally and allow this to cook on low to medium flame. Within 3 minutes, our jaggery syrup will be ready because we don't have to form any string consistency. Here you can see this jaggery syrup is sticky. At this stage, switch off the flame and add crushed cardamoms. As the jaggery syrup is ready, here our oil is also well heated. Once it is well heated, transfer all the khajas and reduce the heat to completely low. These khajas should be fried in low to medium flame, and also the ladle should be rotated in the oil like this very gently so that the oil goes inside each layer and each layer is cooked properly. Turn to all sides and fry the khajas in a medium flame. Otherwise, outside layer will be fried but inside will not be cooked. Once they are well fried and turned to golden color, strain them and transfer to a separate plate. Immediately after removing from the oil, transfer to the jaggery syrup so that the jaggery syrup will be absorbed properly. And also make sure that the jaggery syrup is still warm enough. Otherwise, you may heat little bit before transferring the khajas into the jaggery syrup. Allow the khajas to sit in the jaggery syrup for 5 minutes and then remove. With this, here our perfect sweet shop style khajas are ready, and here I'm breaking one piece for you. You can see how juicy it is inside and crispy outside. So friends, try making this crispy, soft, juicy, delicious khajas and surprise your family on special occasions. If you like this video, please consider subscribing to Homemade Flavors and press the bell icon for more healthy and interesting recipes. This is Rupa signing off for today, and see you in the next video. Thank you.